According to statistics in 2023, the US consumes about 2,600 million pounds of pork trotters at a price of about $3.5 pound. This is an attractive number for farms raising and processing pork. So how do farms raise and process pork trotters? Let's find out with Trending Farm today. Seaboard Foods Farms, a prominent pork company, operates numerous pork production facilities across the United States. The flooring consists of concrete or metal mesh to facilitate the drainage of waste. Automatic feed and water supply systems ensure a continuous provision of food and water to the pigs. Waste management includes collecting solid waste manure in pits or ponds, while liquid waste urine undergoes processing in a wastewater treatment system. These facilities strictly adhere to government regulations concerning animal health, environmental protection, and animal welfare. What are your thoughts on the scope of this pig farm? Feel free to share your comments below and we'll respond promptly. Have a productive day. Pigs typically reach reproductive maturity between 4 and 8 months of age. Sows undergo an estrus cycle lasting approximately 21 days, encompassing estrus, ovulation, and post-estrus stages. Gestation for sows lasts about 114 days, yielding litters of 8 to 12 piglets. Piglets may exhibit aggressive behavior, leading to injuries, often mitigated by teeth trimming within 1 to 2 days of birth. Trimming focuses on the sharp tips, avoiding damage to the tongue and gum. Skilled workers handle this task to ensure safety. Piglets remain with the mother for 21 to 42 days, gradually weaning onto solid food and water under the breeder's guidance, tailored to each herd's needs. Vaccinating pigs is an important measure to protect pigs from dangerous infectious diseases, increase productivity, and meat quality. Vaccines for pigs are usually administered intramuscularly or subcutaneously. Children will be vaccinated with vaccines such as swine fever vaccine, foot and mouth disease vaccine, Ogiski disease vaccine, swine flu vaccine, and staph vaccine. Each medication will be injected at a fixed time and closely monitored under the supervision of a veterinarian. Share this video with your acquaintances so that both you and them can receive good luck, as well as signals that you should get vaccinated to protect your health. Have you ever wondered how pigs are transported to processing plants? Click the like button on the video for an inside look. Trucks are the primary mode of transportation, requiring proper design for ventilation, temperature, humidity, and adequate space. These trucks vary in size, with lengths ranging from 16.4 to 39.4 feet, widths from 6.6 to 9.8 feet, and heights from 6.6 to 8.2 feet, capable of carrying 10,000 to 40,000 pounds. Transporting such loads demands careful attention to safety and compliance with regulations to prevent accidents. Would you dare to drive one? When brought to the factory, pigs will be kept in a centralized area so they do not panic. Then, they will be treated with electricity or CO2 gas to avoid ghosting during processing. Each pig will be hung by its feet on a hook and put into a hair-making machine using steam or fire. The worker will cut the pig's body in half, remove the internal organs, and take it to the meat division stage. The worker will use a sharp knife to divide half of the pig into three large parts: front legs, hind legs, and belly. During the entire process, the pig is stored in an environment below 4 degrees Celsius to maintain freshness and make it easier for the worker to slice. Next, each worker will be responsible for dividing the meat into parts. Here, the meat will be separated from the bone and divided into pork belly, tenderloin, and ribs. Operations need to be quick and decisive to avoid crushing the meat, affecting the aesthetics and quality of the meat. The pork butt and leg meat will be transferred to the next processing stage. The process begins with defrosting the frozen pork leg meat, followed by trimming the fallen meat to achieve a balanced ratio of fat and meat. Subsequently, the meat is soaked in cold water for 18 hours to remove blood, ensuring a thorough cleansing indicated by the whitening of the pig's feet. Afterward, the skin undergoes intense grilling at temperatures exceeding 500 degrees, enhancing texture and eliminating odors. Workers meticulously cut the pig feet to prevent surface tearing during heating, then immerse them in cold water to remove any remaining blood before freezing the first processed pork leg. After at least one day of freezing, the trotters are thawed for 8 hours. They are then stewed in prepared water, marinated until browned, and cooled for 50 minutes. Next, workers remove any burn marks, preserving the desired flavor, before subjecting the skin to high heat for further smoking. Finally, the finished product is vacuum sealed for packaging, ready to be transported and enjoyed as the delectable dish braised pig's feet, known for its tender chewiness. Pork leg meat is not just nutritious, it's a powerhouse of protein, collagen, vitamins, and essential minerals vital for overall health. Its flavor profile is exceptional, boasting a delightful combination of savory, tender, crispy, and succulent textures that tantalize the taste buds. This delectable dish holds a special place in the hearts of many, earning its status as a favorite among food enthusiasts. Have you experienced the delights of pork leg meat? Share your culinary adventures with us. Stay tuned for more exciting updates by hitting that follow button, and don't hesitate to suggest any processing techniques you'd like to learn more about. Your feedback is greatly appreciated. Deer are mammals belonging to the cervidae family, widely distributed throughout the world. They are known for their elegant appearance, with long horns and soft fur. In China, the Yunnan Meli site is the largest supplier of deer antlers and meat in the country, with more than 30,000 deer and about 3,000 farms specializing in growing food for deer, creating a completely natural breeding environment. The farm is divided into many separate areas to raise deer at different stages of development, ensuring suitable habitat for each stage. The barn system is modernly designed, airy, has a roof and a good drainage system, ensuring hygiene and safety for the deer herd. The livestock area is equipped with a water supply system to ensure deer always have enough clean drinking water. In addition, deer will be grazed semi-naturally at certain times of the day, ensuring their need for regular exercise. Have you seen the potential economic value of this animal? If yes, please leave number one. If not, please leave the number zero. Let's discover how to care for baby deer from birth to adulthood to harvest antlers. The deer's gestation period lasts from 195 to 205 days, with giving birth from May to June. Deer usually give birth to one calf, sometimes twins or triplets. Baby deer are born weighing about 5 to 8 pounds, and are instinctively licked clean of fluid by their mothers. Baby deer depend on their mother's milk for the first few weeks before transitioning to solid food. mother deer nurse their babies 4 to 5 times a day for the first 4 months, even after they start eating grass. Baby deer learn from their mothers which plants are safe to eat and grow quickly, possibly weighing up to 60 to 70 pounds after a few months. The process of raising deer to harvest antlers lasts from 3 to 5 years. Velvet is covered with soft velvet that provides nutrients for horn growth. On average, a deer can give from 220 to 660 pounds of antlers. When the antlers reach the desired size and quality, the deer will be harvested. On a farm, deer are fed a diverse diet to maintain their nutrition and health. They primarily eat leaves from trees like fig, mulberry, almond, chinaberry, and jackfruit, as well as fresh grass, apples, bananas, pears, young shoots, and root vegetables such as carrots, sweet potatoes, and radishes. Supplementary feed, which includes bran, cornmeal, soybean meal, vitamins, and minerals, is provided twice daily, morning and afternoon, to ensure they get essential nutrients. Feeding amounts are adjusted based on age, weight, and health, aiming to avoid overfeeding or underfeeding. Clean feeding troughs are used, and water troughs are kept nearby and regularly cleaned to provide fresh water. Raising adult roe deer is a complex process that involves ensuring optimal conditions for growth and health. Common forages include clover, alfalfa, and many grasses. These plants are rich in fiber and essential vitamins, promoting healthy digestive and metabolic function. To enhance antler growth and ensure the highest quality deer intended for antler production, receive a diet supplemented with concentrates, including grains such as corn, barley, and oats, which are high in carbohydrates and protein. These nutrients are important for the rapid growth and development of antlers. Deer are loaded into trailers with air conditioning and red lighting, helping them feel comfortable and reducing stress during transport. The air-conditioned environment ensures the deer stay calm and healthy throughout the journey. Are you ready to go to the deer meat processing area with us? Don't forget to like and share the video with your friends to get more joy. Once at the processing plant, the deer are humanely handled and hung before workers continue processing. Workers begin by hanging the deer before commencing the skinning process. Starting with the hind leg, the worker carefully cuts around the knuckle and peels the skin away from the bone, being mindful not to damage the tendons used for hanging. Moving to the front leg, similar cuts are made and joints are broken to facilitate skinning. Gloves are changed regularly to maintain cleanliness of the carcass. Pulleys or ropes are employed to lift the deer, aiding in easier skinning and preserving the carcass's hygiene. The skin is pulled down by hand, with a knife used sparingly to cut through tough membranes. Continuing down to the base of the tail, the worker pulls the skin away while ensuring minimal contamination. Demonstrating a technique, the worker uses fists to push the warm deer hide away from the carcass. Carefully shaving around the neck with a razor, the worker removes the head at the joint, ensuring the carcass remains clean by avoiding unnecessary cuts. cutting along the front of the esophagus. The worker pulls it outward to maintain cleanliness. To complete the process, the chest cavity is flushed to remove any remaining blood. Fresh deer meat is then stored in refrigeration at temperatures ranging from 33 to 37 degrees Fahrenheit for 7 to 10 days, ensuring optimal preservation before further processing. Deer meat is a nutritious source of lean protein, low in calories and fat, compared to conventional livestock meats, ideal for those on a diet and looking for a healthy nutritional balance. It also contains heart-healthy omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids, along with rich amounts of B vitamins, vitamin A, vitamin E, and essential minerals such as zinc, selenium, and iron, which are very important for ovulation. Deer meat can be prepared in a variety of ways, including grilling, stewing, sauteing, and roasting. Grilling deer meat at high temperature for a short time helps preserve its natural flavor and nutritional value. Deer meat stewed with vegetables helps increase the flavor and nutritional richness of the dish. Stir-fried and grilled deer meat with vegetables is also a popular choice. Additionally, you can combine deer meat with bread. What dishes from deer meat have you experienced? Please share with us in the comments section. To learn more about deer meat and discover delicious recipes, support our Trending Farm channel on YouTube.
Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. So since we don't really have any clue of what kind of difficulties that you could be facing in your farms, please don't forget to share all the problems you're facing and obstacles you're going through, as this will tremendously help us with our upcoming videos.